Hey, welcome back to the Mr. Excel Netcast. I'm Bill Jelen.
Basically, you start out with massive amounts of data. You say, how are we going to analyze this? Well, let's fire up a pivot table and see if we can solve this problem.
Hey, welcome back to the Mr. Excel Netcast. I'm Bill Jelen. Well, it's Wednesday. In real life, I'm on my way home from Seattle right now, but I'm recording these ahead of time. Another question that came in, this one took me a while to figure out. They said, you know, down in the drawing toolbar, why don't they have a semicircle? And, you know, so if we go into basic shapes there, you know, we have the oval and all kinds of things. And so I can use the oval. If I hold down the shift key, I can draw a circle with the oval. All right. And then in basic shapes, now this is an Excel 2003, you can drag this off here. In basic shapes, they have this block arc. And again, if I draw the block arc, I thought maybe I could play with this yellow inflection handle and get it to fill in. There it is. So that's one way of doing it. And then he said, you know, like a left, top, up, and right. So hold down the shift key while you grab the green rotation, and you can. It looks like there's about six stops between each 90 degrees when you're dragging with the shift key. Now in Excel 2007, I was curious to see if there was anything here under shapes. They renamed auto shapes to see if they had added a semicircle. They have this chord, which is interesting, not exactly perfect, I don't think. And then the pie. It turns out that the pie is a really good way to go. If you draw a pie, and again, hold down the shift key to make sure that it starts out circular, then we have a couple of inflection points. And I'm going to hold down the shift key while I drag. And I'm going to drag that shift key around till it's just perfect 180 degrees. And now I have a semicircle. And again, using the shift and rotation, I can rotate that around to a semicircle. So, you know, why don't they have a semicircle? Well, they have a couple of different ways to get there. Yeah, they're not perfect, I would guess, but still, beyond the shapes that are in there, using those yellow inflection handles and then the green rotation, all kinds of ways to take the built-in shapes and make them into other types of shapes. Also, don't forget, holding down the shift tends to make the oval into a circle, makes the rectangle into a square. The other one that I like in the auto shapes is if you hold down the Alt key, it will stay constrained to a certain number of exact rows and columns. So you can have something that will perfectly fit in the rows and columns by using the Alt key. There you have it. Thanks for stopping by. We'll see you next time for another Netcast from Mr. Excel.
Thanks for stopping by. We'll see you next time for another Netcast from Mr. Excel.